우리 벨라루스 음식 먹지.
I'm tired of eating green stuff.
이게 다 뭐예요?
그런 거 없어. 그냥 먹으면 되는 음식이지.
Oh my goodness, more sugar? There's more sugar in this?
To our what we eat in a day video, international family and baby edition. So today we'll be sharing with you what we eat in a typical day. And actually, since we are filming on a weekend, it's not a very typical day. We tend to eat very simple and very quick and healthy meals throughout the week, and then on weekends is when we really tend to relax and have some of the things that take a bit longer to make and might not be quite as healthy but are a little bit more fun and delicious to enjoy. So for breakfast today, Stella is having a puree of banana, pear and blueberry, and that's when she works on feeding herself with a spoon. So I'm usually feeding her with my spoon and she's holding her own. She's gotten pretty good about putting it in the bowl, grabbing some, and then maneuvering it over into her mouth. So she's been enjoying working on that skill. Once she's done with that and has her first bottle of milk, usually by then Dad is done with making breakfast, and while we're eating our breakfast, she's next to us working on her finger food for the day. So today she was having a blueberry pancake, so she will be eating that while we're eating our breakfast, which today is my egg toast. So a very delicious addictive toast that Joonyoung found a recipe for, and he'll be cooking that for us, and that will be our breakfast for the day.
To start, you're going to need 2 pieces of bread per person, because otherwise the egg soaks through the first layer, falls to the bottom, and burns just like all of your dreams. We've got Japanese mayonnaise and some garlic salt. What is he doing? Okay, the crevice, we do need to make the crevice. That is important for the egg to not slide off of the bread, so do that. Don't tap the bread. You don't need to tap the bread. Yes, put the mayo on, make a nice border around. Pile up more sugar than you've ever had in your entire life. Season it. Oh, look at those dumplings. They completely failed. You're not going to be seeing them again. Place the bread inside the air fryer first and then the egg, otherwise the egg will slide off as you try to move it to the air fryer. More seasoning on top. Oh my goodness, more sugar? There's more sugar in this? Oh, and there goes the egg. The poor egg suffered for the shot. Don't tell your air fryer, but do try this. It is so, so good.
For lunch, Stella is having a chicken soup. Soups is what we turn to for lunches because it's very typical for Russian culture. Today it's a more simple one. It's just got chicken, potato, carrot, celery, red pepper, onion, and garlic, because I've started adding those since they are very important ingredients in both of our cultures. While I'm feeding her the soup, because that's a little bit more difficult to scoop up properly with a spoon, so she's not working on that one just yet. Instead, she's working on self-feeding bread and cheese, because cheese has somehow become a favorite food of hers. So that's usually what she's doing while I'm feeding her the soup, and then she does have another bottle of milk right after that.
자, 우리 점심 뭐 먹어요?
우리 김밥 먹어요.
김밥 먹을까요?
김밥 is like Korean style sushi. It's basically rice with bunch of veggies. And today we got donkatsu kimbap. There's donkatsu in it.
So donkatsu is kind of like a Japanese schnitzel. And I would say kimbap is then more similar to a sandwich versus sushi. So it looks like sushi, but the ingredients inside are almost more like a sandwich. So 도어지 갔다 왔어 오늘?
I got my hair cut, and on the way back, I stopped by Jumbo Market. It's been a while since I shopped in person.
Been a while since someone except for me has cut your hair, so congratulations. You're looking back to normal. We'll quickly show you what else he got, because he spent about 20 minutes and got $200 worth of groceries in the Korean store. Manas is what did you buy? I
bought garlic. Garlic
and garlic.
And
kimchi.
And kimchi.
And lunch. What is this? This is a
gift. Garlic
and garlic, just hot pepper powder. So it's for a lot of the Korean cooking we'll do at home. This is the kimchi. Not really a Korean house if you don't have this. And then the rest is all of the stuff that is a surprise. So here we've got an entire box of ramen and a little tiny bag of ramen. This is what we have for emergencies, apparently. Here it looks like he's got some of the frozen udon, so we're gonna have some of these for dinner today. So he's got some pre-made, says 냉면, so the cold noodles, champong, which is a spicy like fish soup, and then a katsu udon. We don't typically buy these kind of pre-packaged items, especially before COVID, just because we prefer to cook everything at home to make sure that it's healthy and we know exactly what's going into it. But with COVID and not being able to go out to restaurants, especially with these kind of noodle foods that don't really transport well, this was his compromise, I guess. We've got some banana milk because you really haven't lived life until you've had some banana milk. Maxim, which is instant coffee with sugar and powdered milk, so it's really more of a milky coffee flavored drink. Honey butter chips, which are the original ones that started the trend way back in the day, but they're still delicious as ever. And this is what we're gonna be having for dinner, it looks like. Salchisal.
우리 원래 어떤 음식 먹어요? 한식 먹어요?
우리 원래 너무
헬스한
것만 먹어. 무조건
올게닉.
올게닉 아니면 안 돼.
아니, 한식인지 막 미국 음식인지 벨라루스 음식인지 어떤 음식 먹어 제일 많이?
우리 벨라루스 음식 먹지.
For dinner, Stella had tilapia with mashed potatoes and some spinach. And yesterday, she wasn't a big fan of it, so I actually went ahead and added some sour cream to see if she liked it more because it'll make it more creamy. And she definitely liked it a lot more today. You'll notice she did end up with another plate of cheese on it, and that's because she kept reaching over and asking for something in the area where usually I keep the cheese during lunchtime. So I tried giving her just a little bit, and that's exactly what she had wanted, and she was fine with just a small portion of it. And as a dessert, instead of milk, this time she was having yogurt with some peanut butter.
This is the beef we're having. It is not the tail. Don't correct me if I'm wrong. I don't think it's the tail.
파슬리네. 큰일 날 뻔했어. 블랙 페퍼가 아니고 파슬리.
And there's our cute friend black pepper. Seasoned with black pepper, salt, garlic. Oh, and then have a UFC fight with the garlic. Why are you using your hands to smash that? You've got a knife, sir. Ah, oh, and the sugar is back because this morning wasn't enough. We've got soy sauce, honey because sugar isn't sweet enough apparently, oyster sauce, this is like Japanese cooking wine, sesame oil, and green plum extract. So after you've emptied the entire pantry to make this sauce, you can cut up the two different sized green onions. Do they taste different? I don't think so. We're going to fry them up on the pan, add a whole bunch of pork belly. Use 17 different utensils to stir that around in our giant pan. Add the udon noodles into the boiling water in the back there. Add our onions, add our sauce, mix, 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 mix. Unceremoniously plop the noodles in. More green, where are these green onions coming from? Move the pans around because why the heck not? Start burning some garlic. Add the not tail beef. And then remember that you were supposed to add the butter, so just plop it in now. And there you have it, a very delicious, not at all healthy dinner. But hey, we've got kimchi, and kimchi is a vegetable, right?
우리 저녁에 뭐 먹었어요?
우리 저녁에 볶음 우동 그리고 살치살 구이.
주말이면 항상 님이지 요리하는 거죠?
내가 위켄드 셰프야.
그거 언제부터 됐어요?
언제부터일까? 스텔라 나오고 나서?
So before you became weekend morning chef.
Weekend morning chef, Sunday chef.
Because you wanted to always eat tteokbokki.
Tteokbokki.
So he became the weekend morning chef because of that. And then once I got pregnant and I was having a hard time cooking all the time, you took over some of the breakfast and some of the lunches, sometimes the dinners, even after work sometimes you would be making the dinners. Which was hilarious because when we first started living together, you couldn't even peel a carrot. And suddenly this guy who couldn't even peel a carrot was making some of our dinners and sometimes cooking every single day of the week if I was...
I decided to become a main chef because I'm tired of eating green stuff all the time.
But unfortunately for you, we're still eating green stuff all the time. Unlike the video we showed today, we do have a lot of salads throughout the week. It's not our main dish, but it is something that I include in every one of our meals, or I try to, except for when weekend chef here takes over, and a lot of times that excludes veggies. So you'll often find us having a table of like steak, potatoes, a salad, and kimchi. And that's how we combine our cultures, or we might have like chadobegi, but it'll be a chado salad, where it'll have something that I enjoy and that he enjoys together. So before Stella was born, we definitely had, I would say, more balance in having both Korean and European foods. Another cultural thing that I've incorporated into our life that is really hard for him to adjust to is, if you're any kind of European or Russian, you would know this is tea time.
Thanks to the tea time, I'm gaining a lot of weight.
I don't think it's that. Do you want to look back at all the food we ate this today, just today?
이거는 아침 음식이야. 이거는 점심 음식이야. 이거는 저녁 음식이야. 그런 거 없어. 그냥 먹으면 되는 음식이지.
맞지. Yeah, in Korean culture, all food is the same food. So for breakfast, you will have rice, soup, and side dishes. And for lunch, you will have rice, soup, and side dishes. And for dinner, you will have rice, soup, and side dishes. So now that Stella is sleeping, it's time for us to go ahead and have that tea time. We hope you guys enjoyed getting a look into what an international family and baby eat in a day, even though it's not the most representative of what we have throughout the week. And until next time, hope you stay safe.